Well, each of the teams has a union rep. The way a union rep is nominated is the players get together and they choose the following way. They have a team meeting and they say, who wants to be the union rep? Crickets. Nobody. All right. Nobody wants to volunteer. All right. They look at the young guy and say, you can be the union rep. Because normally the union rep has responsibilities to communicate with the union, to be on a few calls. When there's an issue that the players are having, they go to the union rep to talk to the union. Not too many issues of consequence. But during times of COVID and labor grievances, labor fighting, labor discussions, union reps take on a much bigger, much more time-consuming role. So there's 30 of them. Then on top of that, in the union, there's an 8-person executive council. That's 8 players. We've said on Nothing Personal that 3 of those players, James Paxton, Elvis Andrews, and Andrew Miller, are Scott Boras clients. Those are 3 of the 8. So all 38 have a vote. 33 out of 38 said, no, we will not agree to MLB's last offer. Everyone was despondent yesterday. That's it. There's no baseball. Now Major League Baseball is going to have to implement a season. There's going to be more fighting. There's going to be angry players. There's going to be players who choose not to play. By the way, half the people have COVID. By the way, the spring training facilities are closed. Then yesterday evening, Major League Baseball, by the way, let me tell you what I was doing. So I go on CBS Sports HQ. I'm talking about the fact that the Major League players voted no. We do a segment, but then I'm on call, which means that I have to pay attention. I've got to follow Twitter. I've got to look at the news. I'm looking at CBS. I'm looking at other sites, waiting for Major League Baseball to see what they're going to do next. While I knew exactly what they would do, they were not going to implement a season so quickly because they don't want to implement a season. The reason Major League Baseball does not want to implement a season is that they have no great interest in a grievance that the players could file. They have no great interest in the narrative that they had to impose a schedule on the players. But there was a big confusion that we clarified on HQ last night and again this morning, and I'm doing for you today, June 23rd, 2020, or whenever you are listening to this podcast or watching on YouTube. Major League Baseball, in a late-breaking statement, there was another battle of statements yesterday, in a late-breaking statement, Major League Baseball said, all right, players, we need to hear the following from you before we can impose a schedule. It didn't say before we will impose a schedule. It didn't say we're going to impose a 60-game schedule or a 50-game schedule or a 70-game schedule. What they said was, we need to know how quickly you can get to spring training. Let us know by 5 p.m. on June 23rd whether you can all report to spring training by July 1st. Now, I grant you, we may not know exactly where spring training is going to be because it's got to be in the home cities now. Can't be in Florida and Arizona unless you're the Diamondbacks, the Marlins, and the Rays. And also let us know if you agree to the health and safety protocol. Remember that 67-page document that baseball had? The 113-page document that National Basketball Association has? Well, there's that document for baseball, those 67 pages about no spitting and showering and all the other rules and regulations of contact tracing and social distancing and not everybody in the clubhouse at once, not everybody in the food room at once, and yada, and yada, and yada. So everyone said, that's it. Rob Manfred has now imposed a schedule. It's doomsday. These players and owners can't get it together. They're a bunch of tone-deaf, greedy millionaires, billionaires. And I said, wait, that's not what's happening. What's actually happening is that Major League Baseball is proceeding under the March 26th agreement, which specifically states, one, players will get their pro rata share however many games are played. Two, owners will work with players to formulate a schedule because the schedule has something that there was no discussion of. It's called opponents and days that you're playing. where you're supposed to be flying to. Those things are all necessary so that the traveling secretary can make hotel reservations, so charter planes can be made and reserved, so that stadiums can start being retrofitted in order to accommodate the new health protocols. MLB, under that agreement, started that conversation by submitting a list of questions to the union saying, we need you to answer those questions. It's expected today that Major League Baseball Players Association will respond to those questions in the affirmative. They will say that they can report to spring training by July 1st. They will say, we are willing to agree to the health and safety protocols with the following changes, which will cause another conversation. What I am hopeful will happen and what I'm looking to see happen is that all of these additional conversations will eventually result in not Rob Manfred and the owners imposing a schedule onto the players, but will result in an actual agreement for the 2020 and 2021 season. There are still so many variables. Even with the union today agreeing and answering the questions that the owners asked, more discussions are needed. More rules will have to be not just implemented, but discussed, and a plan will have to be made with employees of the teams in operations, stadium operations, traveling secretary, managers, coaches, GMs. There will have to be a discussion as to how a schedule can be played. All of this under the umbrella of COVID and the reality that people are testing positive. Staff members are testing positive. Players are testing positive. Forget a second wave. We're in a first wave. What am I expecting today, tomorrow, the next day? I am sticking to what I've said from the beginning on Nothing Personal. An opening day around August 1st. Spring training around July 1st, July 4th, around Independence Day. And I am hoping that somehow we can again flatten the curve. Somehow we can again reduce hospitalizations, reduce positive tests. But I'm also hoping that players understand the responsibilities that they will have once a season starts. Because the worst nightmare, let me say it a better way so I'm not insensitive. The worst nightmare is people dying from COVID-19. The worst nightmare are people getting COVID-19 and having the potential for respiratory illness for the rest of their lives. Unknown side effects. That's the worst nightmare. The second worst nightmare is starting a season of however many games there are and not being able to finish.